The Joy Business Van, empowered by Joy Business and supported by EcoBank, the Pan-African Bank.
It's a few days to Ghana's Independence Day celebration, and somewhere at Jamestown in Accra, Mohammed Awudu, a versatile fine artist, is busy at work. He's been contracted by beverage company Guinness Ghana to do one of the things he loves the most, street art. Today, he's telling Ghana's independence story from his perspective and what he wants to see of the country in future. This is what Mohammed, who works under the signature name Mo, does for a living. Mo was born and raised in the Zongo community of Nima. He discovered his artistic skills very early and he pursued it.
I was very young, around the age of nine or ten years back in primary school. So after my junior high, I enrolled to an art college. So I started discovering that I can make money from art. So from there, I used to do paintings, take them to art center, sometimes at exhibition. That's what I used to pay my fees and all that. So from there, I think I've been doing art every day.
But as Mo progressed, being an artist became more than a money-making venture, but an opportunity to rebrand and affect his community. He called it Reimagine Nima.
I try to put the different cultures that we have in Nima so that people outside will have a better perception about us rather than hearing it from other people. So from there, I think last year I had more than 50 or 100 tourists from all over the world, and now people are free to come to Nima.
More street art in his community is what will shoot up his career. More people started noticing it, and not too long, he would be exhibiting his graffitis at one of Ghana's popular art festivals, Chaluote.
Every year at Chaluote, my work, I think, stands out. When you go around town, when you come, like, around Jamestown, Nima, when you go to Su, all these places, when you go there, you find my works and people call me and say thank you Mo for giving us part of you. So I feel like, and I make a lot of I get a lot of contracts through these days that I do for people, and I feel like so proud.
Mo has become one of the most sought after artists by corporate entities like Samsung and international bodies like UNICEF. His skill has also opened international doors, and now Mo considers himself an ambassador for Ghana, projecting the country in a very positive light to the international community.
Yeah, now people come to Nima to learn our ways, our culture, because Nima is made up of all different kind of people from different backgrounds, Muslim, Christian, yeah, traditionalists. Everybody can have everybody there. So now people begin to come there and listen to our story. People come there to bring out business.
But the industry still has a long way to go, he tells me, from poor appreciation of art to the lack of support from government. He believes there is more potential that can be tapped.
When you look at our overpass, our city is dry. It's dry. All they put is Ghana flag. We need to represent our history on the world. We need to encourage, know that we have culture. Art is one big thing. It's bigger than music, but people don't know. It's the most expensive thing in the world.
And if you thought that street art doesn't fetch money, our research shows an artist could earn between 3,000 and 60,000 Ghana cedis for a good art piece, or even more. Mo hopes to raise more artists in his community and is looking forward to executing more international projects.